Can I speak like this? No. Because it seems so unfair. I invited all these people and then to give them my ass. Not that I haven't done this on Hollywood Boulevard before. I'm joking, of course. And I want to know how these six people got seats. What do you know? Okay. Well, ladies and gentlemen, invited guests, street people, trannies, guys dressed up like superheroes, and Scientologists. I want to thank you all for coming out today and standing in the broiling sun at 11:30 on a Tuesday morning. You really find out who your friends are on a day like this. I'm working here, Mr. Trump. Okay, can you move it along? But I would like to thank the organizers. They did a terrific job, and they made terrific speeches, and I appreciate that. I would like to thank Larry King. When I heard I was going to get a walk on the Star of the Walk of Fame, I said, there's one person who I want above all to make this speech. Piers Morgan. But he was busy. Larry King graciously stepped in. I also want to thank my good friend Seth MacFarlane for being here. I know to be up this early, he had to drink straight through. And I want to thank some very special people, without whom I would not be here today. George Bush, Sarah Palin, and the Pope. But also, if you look at this crowd, so many people I've worked with over the years. I can't remember their names, but I know they're very good friends of mine. Sheila, you keep files on who my friends are. Please send them each a case of steaks. Anyway, I just want to say to the Scandinavian tourists who are out there wondering who I am, I was the construction worker in the village, people, so I will be signing autographs after for you. But I will make my remarks brief today. Not that I don't have a lot to say, I have 26 unused Emmy speeches. Before this, the biggest honor I've had in this town was having my picture hung up at the dry cleaners. But as you know, I don't believe in God or faith or anything like that, but this is the very spot on which I used to paint myself silver and act like a robot. So this means I was hoping it would be next to a head shop, but when I came to Hollywood in 1983, I had one dream. To sleep with Jodie Foster. That didn't work out, but this is nice too. Thank you very much for coming. I really appreciate it. It means the world to me. I'll treasure it. Thank you, everybody. Let's unveil the star and ask Larry King and Seth MacFarlane to join us.